Welcome to the stream. My stupid thing was already up, so I'm fixing it now. My stream wasn't supposed to actually be on, but I think because of some weird issues, my stream was still up. The actual Twitch website was up. But welcome, everybody. Welcome to the stream. Doing some more Alan Wake tonight. I don't know how much we're gonna finish up. I don't remember how long the specials are, the episodes, and then, you know, if we get through them tonight, of course, we will jump right into Alan Wake's American Nightmare. I did download that, like, right before I went live, and now I have to hear the music of the game kicking in, because the music was too loud, it was messing with the music, so here we go. Special one,
previously on the Alan Signet. Wake. Something I only know is the dark presence held my wife captive and used her to write a horror story that came true.
I'll bring her back.
Some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story.
Hope I'm gonna say, yeah, we should be fine. We should be fine.
Alan?
I saved Alice, then wrote a better ending for the story. But not without a price. I was trapped somewhere in the dark place, a strange zone somewhere beyond our world.
It's not a lake, it's an ocean.
Special feature one, the signal.
After the completion of any difficult undertaking, there are mixed emotions. Accomplishment and relief. Sadness, depression. For a while, everything was about the work. Like an illness, it consumed you. Changed you. You locked yourself away from the world to do it, and now you need to recover. Learn to live without it. Find a way to crack open the door and let the light back in.
This really was like the first DLC that I ever truly bought for this game, or for any game really.
But wrong somehow.
Alan Wake DLC.
Welcome to the.
Oh.
Everything had a surreal, dreamlike quality.
I wonder if that's where they got the idea for the.
Can't believe it.
Oh man.
I had a disturbing feeling.
The people in control.
I had no idea why I was here or where I had been before this moment. But something was waiting for me at the back of the diner.
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
It's distorted because he's dead? But even the name of the diner was distorted.
I just came along, Mr. Planner. I can't believe
that.
It. I'm having a conversation with
Vanilla. She's, slightly transparent. They both are. They weren't like that at first,
are
though,
you
right?
On your own, or is your wife with you? I can show you the town if you want. I get off work at 6.
I couldn't leave.
Maximum hoage.
The eerie feeling of being carried along in a nightmare grew stronger.
Oh, that's cool. Make the coffee cup blink in and out of existence. So I wonder if the whole distorted thing
flavor, Sonny.
Was what.
Really a tune right now. Number 6 in the jukebox.
So cool.
I do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep.
And I really flew through this game in 2 nights because I'm like, I feel like I just heard this dude say that a minute ago, but it was like 2 days ago. Let's just do it.
Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
Went right in.
You
put them both together.
Just because we're brothers, don't
they give it a whack?
Murder,
oh yeah.
You in your sleep.
Yes, that's my favorite tune.
The board, there it is.
Oh, Lord. Talking about
I was so messed up, I couldn't think of the name of what I was looking for, but. I feel like this. Oh, alarm clocks. I was right.
You can hurt yourself in the dark.
That was very cool. So it feels like this is probably where they got the idea for the board with their distorted dialogue. We definitely went this way. I don't remember if I have to do the exact same stuff. That's cool. And I believe this is where we meet
Alan,
Mr. Scratch.
Listen to me.
Oh no.
Go no deeper.
What?
Focus. You're losing yourself.
I need a mute button for when I have to freaking cough. But I do have the sensor button.
Find a point of contact.
I hope that worked.
What do you mean?
I cannot hear you. Please, you're the one making all this happen. Concentrate. This is what's happening.
Nightmares. Too deep. Can't take the pressure. It's too much.
Suddenly, Wake found himself face to face
with himself. This is why I thought that the guy that was the live action actor was the actual voice actor. It was stuff like that. Like, he sounded like him to me when I would watch some of the live action stuff. Oh, what's that? Was he giving me a light? Yeah.
It's not the light itself, but what it represents. You will need it.
This would be a good picture moment right here. I mean, he didn't really put his hands around it, but that's okay. Mira was here.
This is not a gun. It is a tool and a logical process of elimination.
Thanks, Max Payne.
Be careful. I will try to find a better point of contact.
I didn't understand Zane's message, and knowing where I was didn't fix anything. Something had gone wrong after I had finished departure.
I wonder if they had this rendered when they made the original game. Because you don't actually come in here. Oh, there's a radiator up top. I don't think I've ever seen that before. A radiator, like, on a shelf. That's interesting. To me, it's totally relevant, but it's interesting to me. Finally.
What the hell was that?
It's not freaking tinted orange, which means now it looks nice. And we can run.
Day had come back. The diner had become deserted. Then the door was smashed off its hinges and Wake had to fight for his life.
Oh, okay. I still have to go around. This definitely reminds me of... Oh, there it is. This, oh, hello. Okay, I have tons of ammo. Oops. Okay, welcome. Welcome to the stream. If you haven't missed... really anything. We're still in the beginning. Ooh, okay. Oh, crap. So far, all that's happened is we came into the diner. We went into the bathroom that didn't exist last time. Ooh, we can't do that twice. This is a terrible spot for me. I just need him to... Oh, whoops. Oh, my goodness. I got it. Oh, this was... Yeah, that was dumb. That was dumb. That was dumb. So all that's happened so far is we went into the diner. It literally starts up with him walking into the diner, and then it's just like the very beginning of the game, except everyone's voices are distorted. We went in here. Thomas Zane talked to us. He gave us the light. He gave us the gun. And then I lost because I sucked. That was about it. We're gonna go this way. Plus, you can do this. This is one of my favorite... Nope, there it is. There it is. That's one of my favorite things about this game. It's so minimal, but I love it. That when the camera takes over, you can technically still move your character. I didn't even go anywhere because of the the booth in my way. Oh, you know what? Oh. I'm just gonna... I didn't even know he was right there, but I'm gonna take this. Oh boy. What I really need is a flare right now. Okay. Oh, wait. Wait, oh, well, all right. He was about to kick it. He was about to kick it, and he didn't, so, okay. Take three, take three. It's funny.
What was that?
This is actually a challenge.
The diner had become deserted. Then the door was smashed off his hinges and Wake had to fight for his life.
I'm gonna do it this way. And I can focus. I saw him doing it, but I was like, I'm just gonna go for it. I just need to kill you now. What the heck? This diner. Whoa, is this the worst tactical spot on earth? All right, we're just gonna book it then, because I was almost out last time. We just need more open space, because it's not gonna work here. But I am gonna do that and just try to get some in on him, because I can get these guys out. I just need to. Ooh, okay. I thought he would. Dang. Yeah. I did not need to. I don't need to collect stuff. This. Oh, man. This is so dumb.
What the hell was that?
Jay, the diner. Okay.
I gotta pick. My OCD's not gonna let me not pick up that clock. So I'm gonna try to actually take everybody down. Reload. I think. Oh, I can't believe he actually missed. Alright. Bear down on this guy. Ooh. All right. Whoa. Okay. All right. Now we got it, though. Now we got it. Because all I have to do is take him down and everything's fine. Oh. Okay. I can take my alarm clock. Totally pointless, but it is what it is.
Zane, wait for me.
Oh. Oh, I didn't expect that to vanish like that. Twisted.
These trees didn't belong here.
Yeah, this one gets really weird. Like, with it being a special, that's one of the things I remember about this, because it's this weird alternate version of the city and everything that you've quit. Oh, I thought he would have. Thought he had a little bit more in him to run. Oh no. Okay. Hey, there's that painting. Yeah, this one I remember gets real different as you go through.
I knew it was my writing, but the words were jumbled dreamlike fragments, reloading frantically.
The edge of my screen has like this tiny little strip that is really distorted as like the camera spins around. Verizon. Oh my goodness. Verizon Navigator.
I hadn't expected that.
I remember that. Oh man, that's funny.
Hello? Yes.
Listen, I can help you.
Good.
You're drifting deeper. I can't reach you. You must come to me. I can't maintain the connection. Use the words. Follow the signal.
I have to wonder now if they did that on purpose.
It made
with
no
the Verizon
sense
joke.
GPS
like, can you hear me now?
I doubted any satellite was in range here.
Oh, man.
These were alien skies. But it was guiding me towards something. Towards Zane?
Ooh, pick it up. Ooh, yes. All right. Oh, okay. That's nice. Hmm. Maybe we go back out front.
Something had shifted again.
The dark. And now we're across the street from the diner.
It wouldn't stay still.
The town itself turned against Wake. Cars flew toward him. It cracked bone and crushed muscle. It oozed hate. It wanted to bury him.
I like the random lone chair. Just something about the chair just... oddly creepy. As long as we... I was gonna say, as long as we stay behind... You know what? Let's just... I'm not 100% sure if I got hit by that. I don't think I did, though. Come on. Ooh. Close, but no cigar. Nope. All right. Oh my god. Oh, and it still got me. That was almost a really cool dodge. Ooh. Okay, this thing's about to take me down. I think I destroyed it right before the flare. I ended up shooting the flare off, so that actually kind of sucks. This one's also he turned too far. Nope. All right, screw that. I just never do that in time. I'm in the worst positions tactically. Okay, I thought they got behind me, but they didn't. I'm glad he's like fairly slow.
Was familiar, and yet it wasn't.
Same, but different.
Hello.
I cannot keep up. You're going too deep. I will try to guide you. Follow the signal.
I'm trying.
You must face yourself. Follow me. Oh.
The GPS system was supposed to lead me to Zane, but the shifts were interfering with it. I had to keep trying. I wouldn't survive alone.
I guess we just go up here. We're following the light, but I do have to see if this will actually open for us. Okay. They have so much stuff where you can look inside the windows and it's rendered, but you can't actually explore any of it. Which I think comes from the main game.
The street wasn't so much ripped apart as it was missing. Like some great hand had reached down and scooped it up. Everything felt erratic, unstable.
This is a cool one. It's kind of like the flash grenade, flare, and tool. Like, it just keeps going. Oh, there's a standee to find, because that creeped me out for a second. I'm like, what the F was that? It just keeps going. Oh, and that's the end. All right. And It goes right through this building, which is just a really random thing that I like to do. Random debug stuff, that's always my favorite. Supplies. Yeah, if you like to write, this game will either make you want to write more or it'll make you want to stop. Because it depends on how crazy things get for you. I would say if you need anything to inspire you to write, Bakuman, which is a manga that I read, absolutely amazing. It's made by the people that made Sarah Breaker, Bright Falls Finest, the red hot cop chick with the lightning fast boomstick. Her debut book, The Only Girl in the Bookhouse, delves deep into the double life of having a successful law enforcement career while being involved in a secret society. How does Daddy's Little Trooper fit into an old-fashioned fraternity? Alright. But it's made by the creators of Death Note. Which, it's almost like, it's slightly autobiographical, because this is apparently what they do. But one person writes the story and one person does the art. And that's what Bakuman is. And it's like this one guy who wanted to become a mangaka. Oh crap, it's a buttload of stuff I'm dealing with. All right, we're gonna do this. It's about a guy who wanted to become a mangaka, which is a manga creator. And his buddy that he ends up teaming up with in high school, who does all the art. And it's there basically, oh, okay, all right. Relax, folks, relax. Jesus Pete. It's basically about their journey of trying to make the number one manga in Japan. And it's actually really, really good. To do this. Okay. That definitely worked. Yeah. Old Leviathan. Yeah, that's the new one they made, right? Is that the people that made Cold Leviathan? I know they had some new manga that they did. I just didn't end up reading it. And I don't know if that continued or not. Although it also has an anime. I know the anime, I believe the anime went through the entire manga. Because it was one of those anime that I knew had, like, multiple seasons. A little bit of assistance.
Okay. Where are you? Look, I'm trying to follow your goddamn signal.
The dark place is playing tricks on you. You're still going deep. I'm trying to guide you, but it's hard.
What is this?
I can help you if you just stop sinking.
What? This is bullshit.
It's happening again. Brace yourself.
Good. I think that's where we're going.
It was ridiculous, but I was more scared than amused. I felt like I was being hindered by an unseen force in ways I couldn't fight. All I could do was keep going.
Yeah, Cold Leviathan definitely sounds... Well, it definitely sounds familiar to me, but I don't know if that was them or not. But I think theirs did have, like, code in it, or it was something where... Ah, boy. Oh! Oh, that was a very last-second dodge for me. Hey. Good thing they suck. Alright. Get this guy first. Oh, okay. He just. Uh-oh. Oh boy. All right. Dang. Too late. All right. This is oddly difficult. I don't think. I'm pretty sure I had the original game on normal mode. Maybe it was on easy and I just forgot. Because I know I did put it on easy at one point. Because I was tired of constantly having to choose normal mode when I was doing all my testing. So maybe I was playing the whole game on easy and didn't realize it. Maybe that's what happened. Who knows? That would explain why it was so hard for me to die. Although, I don't remember dying too much when I first played the game. The game's not really the most difficult game on Earth. Oh my goodness. There we go. Got it. I don't remember if I had it on easy or not. I don't think I did, but that's because I never play on easy. But I was thinking about that. I was like, huh. I do remember hitting easy mode just so I could be like, oh, because they don't start on easy, which I thought was weird. It's not automatically at normal when you choose your difficulty. It's just at the top, which is set to easy. And then you have to press down to put it on normal difficulty. But I also feel like these locations are just tougher in general, because everything so far has been really cramped, and that I feel is what actually makes the whole situation difficult. It's not even the amount of enemies, it's literally just the fact that there's less space for you to run around.
I don't see Barry.
Look, wait, maybe that's him. That's the way to the chopper.
I remember this.
Step inside yourself. I'm like, let's just do this. Gotta burn this stuff away. Instantly. That bounced in a way that I thought I had it. Gotcha. Bounced in a way I wasn't expecting when it hit the tree there. That recharge, because I don't want to waste a battery. I thought I saw a crate back there. That's not. Nope. You can technically read that. That's kind of cool. There's the one of four cars in the game.
I had to find the key to get the door open.
Oh, that sucks. Stay right over here. Try to watch the sides. Okay, I'm like, there's so much stuff moving around and making noise. I don't even know what's happening. Oh. Crap. Well, now I have to destroy it. Or... ah, boy. Stupid trash can. Too close. Oh. What? The heck? I'm not even sure what I just got hit by.
Wait, I got the door open. Run for it.
Yes, tools. That definitely looks like it's about to come to life. Check that out, right?
He couldn't see the ceiling. Something was moving in there. He was lost. He couldn't find the exit.
Asshole.
Well, that sucks.
The shifts were getting more severe. I wasn't sure if the place got
bigger,
or I got smaller. The signal was going haywire. I would have to find my way out of here on my own.
Okay. I think all of these I can use as weapons. Yep. Okay. What do I have? All right. And then whoa! Okay. I do like this. This is cool. Gotta be careful where you're looking. That does make you feel kind of cool. Oh, come on now. I touched the fire, I guess. There might be secrets in here. Let's walk around a bit. Alright. I think this is such a cool concept as well. Like, using the flashlight to bring things into existence. Dang. Oh, it got me. All I need is for those two. Yeah. Now that's fun. Bring this up now. Concept of this is very cool. And it's a cool reimagining as well. To go through and, like, you get the memories and you go through
Zane left me a page.
Familiar locations. But then they shift them around like crazy. Oh, I thought for sure that was going to be another cutscene. Let's go to the screen. And I think you have to get all the words to actually create the page. Oh. The sudden stop.
Yowza.
A friend in need.
Barry. Hey, bestseller. Looking good.
You're not real.
Well, no shit. What gave me away? But the see-through thing? I'm a figment of your imagination. Just like pretty much everything else you see here. Maybe even you.
That's insane.
Yeah, you're right. Everything that happened before made perfect sense, but this is insane. Good catch, Al.
Okay. Okay, look. I gotta get going. The GPS...
The GPS. Yeah, I know. Follow the signal. Got it.
Yeah, so I do believe...
So,
yeah.
Here to help you.
I do believe we get a lot of Barry in this.
Get a grip, all right?
You nag the way the real Barry does. You know that?
Well, hey, you know, be fair. It's not my fault you think I'm annoying.
I don't think you're annoying.
Al, babe, relax. It's cool. Just try to stay on the ball here. You need to do what Zane tells you. He's been here for ages. He's like the expert.
It's a cool way to have the internal monologue, which is kind of like the classic way that...
Anyway, if this is insane and it's all from your mind, what's that say about you?
Fine. Enough. I can't believe I was actually happy to see you.
Oh, come on. Don't shit a shitter, Al. Deep down, you're always happy to see me. Can't lie to yourself. Know what I'm saying?
I must be a sucker for punishment.
You? No, really? And I always thought you went out of your way to avoid trouble.
Thanks. Thanks for that.
So, it's a bit of a classic, you know, the classic thing is, like, you use a different character that the main character is familiar with, and that's how you, actually, do some physics. Cool. But you use a character the main character recognizes, and then it's like, well, this is all in your head, but it's still going to be that actual character because that's what, you know, just like the viewers, that's what the actual character knows them as. So it's like having the character.
That thing in the distance.
Yeah, that'd be the Biltmore sawmill.
How the hell do you know that?
I don't know anything you don't. So why don't you ask yourself that?
And then you get cool moments like
maybe
that.
Maybe you saw a sign for it back in the real world. Or maybe it's the sawmill, because I said it's the sawmill, and now you can't get it out of your head.
Fantastic.
Yeah, sure has given me a headache. Or is that your headache? Do you have a headache?
Barry.
Oh, mama! Hey, Al! I guess the pen is mightier than...
If you complete that sentence, you're fired.
Mightier than the sword.
You're fired.
Okay. I definitely didn't think that it was going to be an actual literal boom. Nice. Such a unique way to fight. And, you know, you use the light to bring in tools and sometimes super random things like random walls that are irrelevant. That's such a good idea.
He can feel it coming. Not even flesh anymore. Just shadows and ghosts and thoughts.
Oh, hold on. Let's try that one. Actually, let's close this film. Ooh, there. Oh, I can't get it. Wait a minute. Okay. Ooh. Bye bye. Yeah, we're gonna go. Oh, fireworks. Actually, never mind. I was gonna say we might as well fire him off anyway just to see. So the boom kills them. I almost went into that. Dang. I was hoping I wouldn't miss. I knew that was my last shot. Boom. Get some tools. So the boom can take them down instantly, which is great. Fireworks drop their shields automatically. We'll count them as shields. Okay, and the booms are decently spread out too. Oh, that went really far. Ooh, I knew there was another one. This is an early defense. Okay. Early defense. Ooh, let me move. What is that? Oh. Oh, I need those. Or I want them at least. I didn't think he'd miss, but I'm very happy he did. Fair trade. There we go. Oh, okay. You can't go into the words. That's what happened that other time. That technically, that does make sense. Oh, Alan. I thought he was just gonna shoot. Like, I didn't... The whole point of that was to not aim. Whew, heard him coming up on me. Okay. A little bit closer. Oh. That was dumb. I'll keep that in mind for next time. That's his turret. Oh. Cool. That light just saved me from a hit. That little thing just saved me. I mean, I probably wouldn't have died from it, but still. The bridge.
You know, you're gonna have to make your way across here. Thinking the solution probably has something to do with those words.
Really? You think?
Yeah! You should probably use them.
Your insight is staggering.
Oh, I know.
And three. I love how it's just moving around. It's very whimsical.
See, this is the way things should be. I give advice, and you follow. That's when things go right. Get up to something on your own, that's when the trouble starts.
Oh, wait, no, this is how it's supposed to go.
Al, I'm not saying anything you haven't come up with first. Big Mint, remember?
Drive a man insane.
No! This is great! And it's probably therapeutic for you, too.
Find a way over there.
Wake's own words, littering the landscape. His books common and discarded, like blood beneath his feet. Hardbacks. Paperbacks turned against him. Trash. Just cheap trash.
I had seen weird transmissions of myself before, but not like this. The version of myself I saw now sounded insane, like a demented storyteller who was out to torment and destroy his protagonist.
Okay. That one actually got me. Jeez. Of all the things, books falling like bricks is the thing that actually got me. Bird books. So, you know what? Just for something cool. Oh man, who just did that?
You gotta be careful. Those are bad words.
Crazy. Oh, crap. Alright, here's how we're gonna do this. We're just gonna run all the way along the side. Okay, I don't have much of anything, so. Alright, that wasn't too bad. That wasn't too bad. Your books came to life. Yeah. I think for most people, if the stories they wrote came, that sucks. Whatever that was, I'm sure I would have wanted. Someone's books came to life. It would just be bad all around.
The earth shook.
Of my six volumes of Scott Pilgrim coming in and attacking me. Full color Scott Pilgrim attacks.
Okay, this is just too weird. You're weird.
Barry, is all this really coming out of my head?
That's just the way this place is, Al. All that random stuff in your head? Imagination.
But you're from my imagination.
Yeah. You know what, Al? Do yourself a favor. Don't pursue that train of thought any further.
I forgot how weird this one was. It really helped make it super unique. Not good. Ooh. Chase the flickering lights to protect myself. Ooh. Aw. Oh. Crap. You know what? Keep it simple. We'll keep it double simple. Yeah, this is cool. I like the unique style of the Thor Anderson. The God of Thunder, the boozing geezer with the anger and the hammer. Come one, come all, face the age of murder and storm. Discovered by Barry Wheeler, this fresh new voice from a bygone era suggests new and innovative solutions to old problems. Don't you dare leave your bookstore without the best-selling self-help book, You're All Nails to Me. Okay. Foreword by Barry Wheeler. Little glimpses into what's happening in the real world now that Alan is stuck by himself.
Open before you can get into the warehouse. That's the way forward.
If I'm making this up, why is it so complicated?
Because you're a complicated man, and no one understands you. But I'm talking.
Barry.
It's definitely cool that it's like it's the continuation of the story, and it's one of those things where. Okay, for a split second, I swear I thought that that was actually someone making a car sound, because that's how... Ah, crap! Oh, wrong button. Oh, we're doing it again. We're doing it again. Oh, boy. Thank you, Barry. Oh, my goodness, the camera. There's two of them. That's okay. We got two cars, so we'll figure it out. Jump down fast.
Oh, that's crazy.
Okay. Car number two. Oh, boy. This one's gonna be done fast. So we'll chase that one, and then we'll deal with this one once everything comes back. Okay. What do I have? Yep, I do have that. All right. Nope. Do this. All right, now we're good. We're good to go. If only that didn't happen, where everything would go black. Whoa! Crap. Okay. Is that another car? It is. Of course it is. Of course it is. Ooh. That takes an odd amount of time. I feel like even though I know it says that you hold, it feels weird that you have to hold it for so long before he actually switches. Crap. We're just gonna go. Huh. Oh. All right. I'm just gonna drive in reverse. So driving towards this stuff clearly doesn't help. Oh boy. I just really want to get this alarm clock. Oh, camera. You dumb camera. We're fine. We're just gonna leave now. I like the near misses. Just what the heck did I even just hit? Jeez. Whoa! Didn't see that one coming. Okay. Why not? I just got an achievement called Right of Way. Okay. I didn't see that one coming. I figured we had to drive through because I'm like, it's big enough to drive into. So that's, you know, I just thought it was going to be like, you have to open it and then you can drive through it. And it's like, you know, hey, if you have a car still, you get to, you know, just go through faster instead of having to run it. I wasn't expecting to like hit three or four possessed people and then like five canisters and just have everything start exploding around me. But entertaining, so I don't mind. I certainly don't mind. I probably should have looked around before I actually dropped. Hunting rifle? Yeah. A memory. Memory on the water.
Hey, oh, the beginning of the game. I thought this was my side of the bed.
Okay, so that was a memory of sex. Which I don't, you know, hey, those are fine. Not what I was expecting, but it literally just starts and ends with, I thought this was my side of the bed, and then they bang. And that's okay. They entered the trap. Surrounded, you gotta remember the good times, I guess. We had nowhere to run. I'm so sick of you. Damn it. You know what? Let me see this. I knew there were gonna be people this way, too. I can't believe he actually missed. Close. Almost got a double on that. Yeah, they are strong memories. So. Making love with your... Well, I guess technically he's the one who's disappeared now. We saved her. Formerly disappeared wife. All of this. I will take that as well. Ooh. Nice. Oh, that's never a good sound, is it? It is not.
No, it isn't.
That there? What is that up there? Oh, it's just a pole. Okay, well, I guess we go through the wood. We'll do this. Right, we're gonna hit him with the flare to back him up. I think he's like right here. There it is. Oh man. Work hard, play hard. Okay. Oh. Oh, come on. If only you could dodge like that in Resident Evil 4, you wouldn't get your head chopped off so much. That'll be fine. Okay. That wasn't too bad. We're gonna kick this, yeah. Huh. Crap. I don't think that made him fall down. What? Oh. There's just constantly a bunch of freaking... Nope. All right. You do start to feel kind of cool. Yeah, the death scenes wouldn't be as.
I think the dust in this place is setting off my allergies.
You're not even really there.
Well, my allergies are definitely here. Listen, allergies.
See, they knew they had to put Barry in. Had to have somebody with you the whole time. From a nice safe distance. Oh, okay. Okay. We are gonna. Not entirely. Oh! Just shoot the thing! Oh, good lord. Alright. Oh, what's this? Oh, I thought that was reflective for a second. That couldn't shoot through. What am I doing? I can leave. let's go bridge first. Okay. Okay.
Stop it! Oh. They're waiting for us downstairs. We don't have time for Alan!
I knew she wasn't really here, but she still made my heart ache. I had saved Alice. But
Alice,
I wasn't
wait.
Even sure when that happened. Was it days ago? Weeks? Longer? I had no way of knowing.
All the freak memories. Alice Wake. I can't. Lactophobic, I would assume is how you pronounce that. I have no idea. I don't think I've ever actually I've definitely seen that word. I'm sure I found this 10 years ago when I played it. The beauty with the nurserific muserific booty. That's lit. I love that the top line always rhymes and they're always ridiculous. The soothing oasis and the seething crisis. The renowned and award-winning photographer's new coffee table book features intensely personal and intimate images from a life haunted by a husband who was never there. Writer's Muse. Pre-orders accepted now. Alice Sweet. Okay. Still. Oh. Okay.
Whoa, that's fast. I guess you gotta run out.
Can he kick that? Something. There's something here. Oh, there it is. Like, you just push it. All right. Should have known everything's a push. Like, oh God, I'm tired already. All right.
Crazy dangerous, Al.
Hey. No. 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 Yeah, that's right. You know what? I'm just gonna shoot him first. There's no point in dealing with all that. What? Shove me with the elbow. I'm surprised he took that hit point blank and didn't dissipate. High speed barrel action. Memory. Candles.
Hey, lover. Come here. I've got something for you.
I could only hope that Alice was all right. I didn't know what happened to her after she left the dark place.
Zane?
Oh.
Is that you?
I've always kind of loved that sound effect.
Hey, hold that pose.
I totally forgot
that
about this.
Like this?
Yeah, but smile a little more. No, that's too much.
I love that if you get closer, he actually becomes like color.
how people go for those dangerous bad boys.
But I'm not dangerous.
Oh, come on. You write about terrible things all the time. People want to think that you're intimately familiar with them. You kill Casey in this book. You need to look a little bit like a murderer. Oh, that's good. Do that again. You look handsome.
And dangerous.
You know, I wasn't sure about the beard before, but I was wrong. It looks good on you. Okay, I think we're done.
Great. I want to get out of this suit.
Hey, things are looking up.
Guess danger is sexy.
That was when I was still working, when I felt like a real writer instead of a fraud. It was a good memory. I wished I hadn't seen it.
Where's the alarm? You know what? I don't need the alarm clock. It's okay. But I can still hear it, so I really want to find it. Is we in his apartment? Yeah. Oh, you know what? Never mind. We'll see. We shall see. We'll see. I like that you can see outside and it's still just the yard we were just in. Yeah. Always gotta see if they have some random doors opening up for you.
Alan, you made it. This area of the dark place is calmer, at least for the time being. We can talk here, but we don't have much time.
Zane, how do I get out of here?
That's what you face. That's you, even as we speak.
Darkness. Darkness coming! Swept him away. Lost. He knew. He knew! He couldn't hold on. He knew there was no way out.
Oh. No, I'm right here,
oh,
Zane.
What's going wrong?
That's not me, it's just...
Wrong?
I don't know, an echo, a hallucination, the dark presence.
No. The dark presence is not responsible for this. You are making this happen. You're trapped in your own nightmares.
I wonder if this was inspired by the thing. Having the light shootout. It's definitely
understand it. He would never make it.
It definitely reminds me of the thing.
Swallowed up in the rising tide of darkness. It was coming. It was coming.
Shut up!
No, Alan, you must be.
Swept away by the gathering insanity. Zane was gone. Wake could feel the pressure. Gnawing at his mind. The darkness wasn't so bad. It was in him. He felt it. He knew the voice spoke the truth. It was just too hard to think. He couldn't make sense.
He's still too confused to listen.
Stop thinking and just let go.
I forgot about that. I'm just gonna use a shotgun just in case. Yeah. We'll go shotgun. We'll go shotgun. Ooh, that was close, but now there's a person in front of me. Ah. You almost can't tell what's possessed and what's just there now. Wish I had more flares, but oh.
The scope of this horror was unmatched. It would have been so much easier to.
Remember, right, we break them down like piece by piece.
Everything you saw was in memory, a stray thought.
Yeah, this I do believe is the ending. I can't even tell what's actually hitting me now. Okay, that explains it. I'm like, I don't even know what I'm being attacked by. I thought I was behind a barrier, but since it was at my feet, I guess that didn't really mean much. Okay, you know what? I think, oh, everything's blocked off. I think I'm gonna save my flare. Oh, she took damage from that. Come on. It's like the best you can do is just dodge and point. And try to figure out what's actually flying at you and what's just stuck on the boss. Oh, didn't see those mounted heads there. Right up, back up there, amigo. Yep, these guys here. There were two. All right. Get rid of this dumb pipe. All right. You know what? I think I have enough. I think maybe not. Maybe, you know, I'll start to conserve. We'll go handgun. Yeah, they're definitely they're not messing around. This is the end. Come on, what in the world? Everything's so crazy. You can't even tell what's actually coming at you. I can barely even see what I'm actually pointing at. Let me just get that out of the way. I think everything else is still, well, as still as a shifting TV can be, I guess. Actually, here we are. And somehow I still got myself hit. Ah. The fact that I can go behind is actually nice. Or not. Maybe not. It might not be. Okay. I think we're okay. I'm just gonna... No, what did I even get hit by? That... I don't know why I did that. Oh, he's out of breath. Look at this, dude. Out of breath. Come on now. Yes, there it is. Okay. Hey, Stucky. Okay. Final battle. I couldn't, and I see it's shaking. I couldn't tell if it was about to jump at me or if everything was okay. Oh, get away from me, birds. Okay. Goodness. Come on. All right. Aw, man. So tired of that.
There you go, Hammond.
Hartman?
It's all in your head. You've been making it up. Really, Wade. Come on. Your delusions.
Mm. That was kind of cool.
Why is this happening to me? Lodge. No. No. Hartman. There's no way out. No way out. No way out. I need to get out of here.
And that's how episode 1 ends, or the special number 1. I think I know this song. But we're gonna have to skip that though, because I saw that my last stream got hit with a little. It was like, oh, you know, we had to mute this specific portion, and I think it was actually, which was it? I think it was like the final, leading into the finale. It was the Poets of the Fall song. It was the actual song.
It's not a lake. It's an ocean.
After saving my wife from the mysterious dark presence, I found myself trapped in the dark place.
Signal and the right turn.
The enemy here. A nightmarish world that exists somewhere beyond the shores of our own existence.
We're the one making all this happen.
Just do what Zane tells you.
Follow the signal.
Is all this really coming out of my head?
The dark place strange tricks on you.
I made my way across its ever-shifting landscape, trying to reach Thomas Zane.
You're trapped in your own nightmares. You're still going deeper.
The writer.
There you go, Alan. It's all in your head. You've been making
it. It looked like he had a different face for a second. Oh, it's because he had Barry's face.
Your
delusions are out of control.
Get out of my head.
Seriously, Al, you need to get a grip. You know reality's different here. See what I mean, Al?
Ugh, I think I'm stuck on this side.
Well, you're gonna have to find your way out of there. I'll wait. Just remember, you're still in the dark place. You know that, right? I don't want to alarm you, pal, but it's sink or swim time.
Fine.
I could feel the pressure mounting. Barry was right. Time was running out. Everything I saw was a dark, twisted version of reality based on my memories and thoughts.
Oh, okay. I'm like, what? Oh man, they got me doing puzzles. Early puzzles? This is not what I'm here for. Okay. We do this. Then I think there's something else that we're supposed to do. I don't remember. I feel like I was stuck here when I first played this, because I couldn't figure out what the heck I was supposed to do. But I don't think you're definitely not supposed to actually jump over this. There's definitely something to do with that. I know the physics have some part to play in it. Oh, you know what? There it is. That's what it, yeah, okay. Thank you, Barry.
I had to accept it. If all of this was from my mind, then I was the one making all this happen. I was literally fighting myself. It was a moment of clarity.
It's the same as him writing himself out of the story. It's like you have to, surprise, you have to almost, it's like his mind is doing what it did initially, where it was keeping everything the same. Fair enough. Fair enough. Oh, I don't even have the guns yet. And I wish I could remember when these actually came out. I'd have to look that up, because
after
I
finishing
feel
departure,
like
I felt finished myself. All I had wanted was to save Alice. After that, a part of me had been ready to just give in and die. But I hadn't given up. Thomas Zane had reached me. I had run across a nightmarish landscape following a signal from him. He kept telling me I was sinking, going too deep. I wasn't sure if he meant the dark place or insanity. Perhaps they were one and the same.
Ooh, pump action shotgun. That's what I'm talking about. Boink. So I think after the signal first came out, I feel like it was a decent amount of time. I think this is locked. Oh, it's not. Okay, well, secrets. More surprises, if you will. That sounded like an Xbox sound effect just now. Oh, because it's the Night Springs video game. It was an Xbox sound effect. The funny things you can put in games when it's console exclusive.
Hey, nice job, Al. So, you really are nuts, huh? Let's face it, we always knew this was coming.
I guess, but I actually feel pretty rational.
Look at those squares around the moon. You guys can't see that, actually. It looks nice. No, you can kind of see it. It's a little bit of square.
Check out the light show behind the lodge.
The pixels.
That's Zane's light.
Oh.
Yeah. You're done sinking now. That means he's just about caught up with you. You better go talk to him.
We're back at the stage. But I think these came out... Honestly, I feel like it was a few months. Because I remember buying the first one. And when I beat it, because it was... I mean, like, we just flew through that, I feel. And so... I kind of remember,
nice.
Excuse me, I kind of remember being like, oh, that's it? And then I had to wait like another couple months before this episode actually came out. Because I don't believe they came out, they definitely didn't come out at the same time. You had to buy them separately. Oh, I forgot about this. And they distorted it and made it all demonic and wrong. Like, I can't sing. I can't get jiggy with this shit. Oh, crap. Why am I using a handgun? I have a pump action shotgun for unlimited dispatching. Give myself some more light. Did that guy just fall? It definitely looked like one of them, like, fell over. Maybe not. Let me... Reload over here. Dang. Oh my god, what you... Oh my goodness, they are just sprinting in on me.
Hey, isn't it kind of ironic that you're a writer and you're threatened by your own imagination? It's like your greatest power turned against you.
That's very deep, but I'm a little busy not dying over here.
Let me reload. Oh! These fireworks are not taking out their, taking out the darkness as fast as I would have anticipated. That was close. Alright, we're good to go. Heck outta here. Actually, let's reload first. Dang, that was it? Four? Oh, boy.
You can get inside now, Al. The big guy busted down the door.
Thank you, Barry. I just keep getting too close, like a second early.
Whoa. See, Al? This is classic you. Always making things complicated.
This is just a memory.
Even your memories are complicated.
Just in case.
Yeah. So, I guess you're gonna need to talk to Zane out there now that he's actually here. I'm just gonna, you know, let you non-imaginary people talk in peace.
You're not coming?
Nah. That was a crutch, you know. Hey, you're moving up in the world, buddy.
Oh, more video games. Eight sprays.
Zane.
You have done well, Alan. Now I can accompany you. You're trapped in your own dream. You must wake yourself up, but first, you have to reach yourself.
For some reason, it's funny to just see him flow in there, and he's just like...
Yes, my cabin. It will not be...
not really moving.
Your previous work can help you.
But he is in a 1970s diver suit, like so. That kind of makes sense. Oh. My pages. My cabbages. Thought I was getting surrounded for a second. Clear night. Yeah. Nice.
The lighthouse?
It's very appropriate. I can help you reach it. But after that, you will be on your own. I cannot enter the cabin now. The Dark Presence made sure of that on our last encounter. You are facing yourself, the parts of your mind that are hard to control. This is not a fight anyone else can win for you.
Hold up. Actually, I'm not sure. I don't know if it's a good idea or a bad idea to do that now.
I was glad to have Zane with me in this place. He knew the terrain, such as it was. And a part of me wondered if he was even human anymore, after so many years in this place.
No! That was a shotgun. Shotgun shells. And another floating video game that is just in the space before the space exists.
The world
That's almost meta.
Down, Wake was lost. He would fall.
Oh.
He couldn't tell which way was up. He would die there, torn apart by the whirlwind.
Love the visuals in this. See, when they get to go even weirder, it's like this is almost just a precursor to them making Control. This has more horror elements, while Control is more just crazy and weird. Like, it's supernatural without the scariness. And then, yeah.
was too hot.
That was not supposed to work.
At this height, the water would be like hitting concrete.
I would highly recommend Control. I was gonna go for that video game. You know what? I'm gonna just to see what happens. See if we can hop back on the house. I would highly recommend Control. You can get the Control Ultimate Edition now. It has all the DLC. Plus, you'll get the free upgrade to PS5 if you do that, which you cannot do. How in the world are you supposed to get that? Unless that. That's interesting. I don't care that much. Okay. But you'll get the free upgrade for the game. So that'll be nice. Which I know people are still quite upset about that, because if you bought the game from the beginning, like I did, including all the DLC from the very beginning, because I'm like, it's Remedy and it's Control, so of course I'm gonna buy it instantly. Sadly, you don't get the free upgrade. And that's not on Remedy. They're just, unfortunately, you know, they teamed up with 505 Games. And 505 was like, nah. Nah. Ooh. Almost want to bring in all the bridge stuff just because. I'll wait for that. How are you? Ah! Ooh. Nope, just shoot him. That's right, get out of my face. I was not expecting that one. Okay. Deadly Premonition, yeah. And Deadly Premonition was basically Twin Peaks, right?
It was made of darkness. He'd seen what it could do. It swept everything away.
I would have to make my way through the swirling mass.
Yeah, I remember. I remember Deadly Premonition. Oh, I thought that was like another him showing up. It was just a weird visual thing. Man, that's so bright. Deadly Premonition. The thing that I remember about that game is actually watching, I think it was Outside Xbox, and they just talk about, they have some really good like gaming lists where they just talk about like random things that some games have. And it was probably when things are too realistic in games, because in Deadly Premonition, if you run out of gas, you will literally have to get out of your car and go like walk all the way back and get gas for your car. Yeah, that's not good.
Stay focused on the lighthouse. If you can reach it, you will find the cabin.
Things are getting pretty crazy here, Zane.
Boy.
It's to be expected.
If only this game were 10 years old, I could see what that says.
The landscape reflects that strain, but each step takes you closer. If you persevere,
1975? 73? It looks like that almost says 1673. Like, it's just about impossible for me to read that, unfortunately. Oh, shit. Hope I get some shotgun shells. Yeah. And we will actually... didn't I have four? Oh, I shot that one guy. I forgot.
I knew what I was facing.
I'm like, I got one bullet, one shell.
Wilder and stranger, like it was no longer even bothering to pretend that things were normal.
Oh. Okay. That was a test one anyway. There's obviously no enemies yet, so those are test barrels. Don't shoot me yet. Oh crap, I did not know it was gonna explode on contact. Okay, that really caught me off guard. That strategy went right out the window. I think every last one of these things came into existence just now. Yep, okay. That was funny though, I wasn't expecting that to. That just makes it funny to me. Cause I'm like, oh, okay, strategy time. Let's get these barrels here. We'll figure this out. And it's like, nope, everything's just going off at once. I think I can technically. Okay. Oh, hello. Hello. Oh boy. Okay. Just hit this one just in case. Good sound effect. Sounds like there's barely anything in it, because it wouldn't sound that empty, but... Good sound effect nonetheless. Reload. Get some respite. Boom. Okie dokie. Finding a typewriter? Oh, the typewriter keyboard. I got my mechanical clickies. Actually, I don't want to hit any buttons because it might throw me out of the game. I'm too scared to do that. Oh, nothing? I thought for sure some eyes would pop up or something. But so far, I like my... Oh, this is very control-like. Or should be one platform and it's spiraling around a tunnel. It's a... slightly reminiscent of Control. Whoa, oh. Yeah. Uh-oh. All right, I have to. I'm like, I know there's somewhere close by. Yeah, as long as we can just keep them backing up. Here we go. Hardly even an issue. Oh, I need to reload. In a second, before I shoot you in the face. There we go. Nope, I'm out. Yeah. Man, I don't remember any of this stuff. This is fun. This is really fun.
Quake was forced to run through a maze, hopelessly sprinting in the wheel, never getting anywhere. His life in miniature. It was useless.
I didn't mention this, but that's a nice TV to have. 10 year ago TV? That's a good TV.
Oh. Now what?
Are we on a Ferris wheel? We're on a Ferris wheel. This is crazy. Man, I don't remember any of this. That's that Remedy design right there. Oh, it's not straight enough yet. That's so cool. What in the world? Yeah, I went through it too fast. It's not, yeah, okay, got it. Oh, typewriter keys, cool. Wake. And they have buttons, like the button press. Right falls. Oof. Oh, crap, it scared me. Guess that means we're taking a dive. Okay. Yeah, see, this is why this is the type of stuff.
Mr. Wade, can I help you with anything?
That's the type of stuff you get with Remedy. They put you on a Ferris wheel where you walk through the video game. That's such a cool idea. And because it's supernatural, it totally fits the game. And then we have to wait on the physics. We just got a save point, so I think we're. Oh, that's a gate. All right. Ooh. So we're either at the halfway mark or we're just about done with this. Yeah. I'm trying to. Yeah, I was trying to judge it. I couldn't tell how high up we were, so I was trying to judge it right because I'm like, I don't want to fall super far, but. I waited too long. The perspective got a little tough for me there. I'm like, I couldn't tell because we're right up on this wall. Oh, okay, that'll help. That helps, actually. Because that way I'll know perpendicular to the... What? Ooh. Still almost died. Uh-oh. There we go. Okay. Wait for this to get normal. area. It's cool that it's up at my health. What in the Alright, so ooh, okay. It's hard to tell, the perspective is a little weird. So okay, I'll just look down, I guess. Through and let me go this way. Oh, we're back here. Oh, okay. Well, that sent me, yeah, that sent me back further than I thought. I didn't realize we were still going through back to the door. Okay, do it again. Here we go. Chaos. Then I mean, that looks far. It's far to me. I mean, nope, still took damage. All right, I think. No, this is right. Okay, this is the right way. I just have to finesse it the right way, I guess. Nope, too far. This is weird. It's weird that this is becoming an issue to me. Because if we do this, that's way too far. I guess it's not. Okay. And then we wait for this to get normal. Because I'm trying to do it early, but you can't. You just have to wait. Maybe. Yes. Maybe. Alright. Yep. And there was another door. Yep. And then we wait for this. Get normal. And then we're good. We should be good to go. It's like in, being in that one scene in Inception, in the hallway scene. Just Ferris wheel style. Okay, so then we hop over here. And then we need to go through here. So if I let it... Yep, yep, alright. Boom. What? It's too much damage. That was odd. Yeah, I think we're supposed to wait a little longer. I think I was just doing it way too early. It's almost like we're going in reverse now a little bit. What? How is that too steep? Okay. Okay. So you can take that fall. And then this I have to just do. That wasn't reckless. I thought for sure. I'm like, okay, that looks like it's more than enough time. Because you have to do this. You almost have to hurry and do this one because otherwise... Well... Ooh. I don't know. I don't know. I'm trying to figure it out in the dimensions of it actually spinning around. And that... Really? Barrel... Thought we'd made it through so much. Okay. Then we do this one. And then we just wait. Or no. Do we wait for this one? I don't. Yeah, so this one, we'll just wait. Hop over. Well, that there's no reason that should have been any version of damage. But okay. And then we'll just wait the whole way through for this one. It'll just have to flip all the way upside down. Yep, we start. Once he shifts dimensions, then I'll try. Okay. Alright, here we go. And then I just get hit by an enemy and killed instantly. Alright. Oh, see. And he's dead again. He's gonna be dead soon. Although that's kind of cool to see. And when it flips upside down, we have ourselves a little bit of security. So I guess we'll wait. But we made it to at least a minute checkpoint. I'm gonna fall off. I'm gonna fall off just like that thing. Okay, here we go. We're just gonna redo it, but let's peer upon your own doom, I guess. I didn't know we had a freezing animation. That's funny. Okay. Do this chunk again. But apparently that was too slow. And for this to curve up. Oh, alright. Nope. No. To do that. Actually, what? Okay. Let's. Okay. Okay. So, yeah, somewhere in between. That's where I gotta run. Come on. Vertical. It looks super blurry in this very specific spot. Maybe it's because it's actually moving, so it has motion blur on it. That was close. Alright. Okay. Okay. It's time to get on my nerve. Ooh, I almost dropped. There's no reason that should have been too steep. Okay. Oh no. Hold on a second. Hold on a second. Okay. Oh, he's definitely dying off of this one. Oh, he made it. Look at that. Son of a gun. Okay, so we fought from that side. Alright, so it's two. I had to make sure for a second. I had to make sure that I was actually even going through two separate doors. But I don't think I am. This doesn't make sense. Because then we're here, and then we do this one. So is this not the same door? Am I going crazy? It has to be different. Okay, never mind. All right. It's this going back and forth. That's what's messing me up. So like. That looks like it should be fine. How is that not it? Because now I don't know what the distance is. And I'm worried to go too late because then we'll just be stuck. So every time I look at it, I'm like, that looks like it's fine. But if I wait until it's actually, like this will probably, okay. Had that been like a little bit further, that probably would have killed him. Just like that. What in the world? Oh my goodness, this is starting to really piss me off. So as we wait. Oh, that's the way to go, and when this happens and it. Okay. Wait for this. As it turns. Okay, I was gonna say, where's that barrel before it comes down hitting me? Yes. And then we go this way. Wait till it gets there. You know. And that's the thing, you can't actually wait for it to be totally vertical, because then this happens. Okay, here we go. Alright, we got it, we made it. I'm just gonna wait. That's the only option here. Okay. Stupid. Huh. What the heck? Okay. So this is the safety net. This is the safety room. We just stay here and wait until this thing goes all the way around. So confused. What? Just what? No, I think that's just... Oh my goodness. We just have to wait for the effing door to... Okay. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. I knew something was weird because I'm like... I feel like when I go down and I go back up, it's the same room. I'm like, didn't we just drop into the exact same room? Okay. That explains why that wasn't working in any way, shape, or form. Because we were just going in and out of the same room. I was just screwing myself over by watching the room flip. And then it confused me. So we don't even have to do anything. All we have to do is just stand here and then the door will pop open and we'll be fine. That's what we were supposed to do. Because I'm like... I could have sworn that when we drop in, we're leaving out the same room. I was confused by the turning. That's all that was happening. All I had to do was wait. Just wait for the thing to open up. Oh my goodness. And then it'll just swing open and we should be able to hop through before it's, before it drags us back. Yeah. Wow. That's amazing. I was screwing myself over. Classic.
An elevator?
Classic, sure, classic. Wow.
Next stop, sanity.
You're doing well.
That did drive me insane. I love how he jumped. Like, oh, what was that?
It's a dream. This is a vast place. Home to forces and beings that are completely alien.
The dark presence.
Yes. I don't know what happened to it after your final encounter.
Is there any way out of here?
Sometimes transmissions can be sent between worlds. You've done this yourself. But to actually leave the dark place, I haven't found a way.
That is astounding.
Oh. Stucky's gas station. Not something I particularly wanted to see, but obviously I wasn't the one in the driver's seat.
Another memory made real. Blake would never make it. The insanity he was facing was already a part of it. In him. His own doing. He couldn't possibly win. He didn't even want to.
Such a forceful animation.
At least the lighthouse was much closer now. I would have to make my way up there somehow.
There it is. Ah, man. What is that? Really far away, boom. Try not to blow these up right now. Cool. Almost at it. I don't know why that didn't do anything to him, but it's fine. We made it down here. Not that there's anything here, unfortunately. Oh. Well, that sucks for me. We're gonna go. We're just gonna go. Oh. That's pretty cool. I like that. There was something there, but it's gone now, I guess. Ooh. Okay. I think these were just... Not entirely sure what... Ooh. Do this the easy way. Six. All right. Oop, not that. No, not that. Okay, now we can do that. Now we can do that. Oh, man. Why can't he get out of my face? Okay. That way if we get cha- Oh, what? Okay. Actually do this while I'm next to it so I don't lose all my ammo. Oh, it's gonna drop on the ground, it'll be fine. Alright.
There was no power to the log lift.
I knew I needed the wires. I thought it was going to be automatic, though. I'm glad he missed. You saw it. It takes the full six. I really don't remember how this one ends. I wasn't expecting it to spin when I did that. But I like it. Physics. Secrets. I don't think this one has anything outside of the games. I think the first episode was the one that had the alarm clocks and the
part of you that is in control is in the cabin, dreaming and insane.
I don't think I like that.
You represent the part of Alan Wake that is capable of rational thought and planning, which is why I'm talking to you. If that part can regain control, then you have a chance of making it. But a part of you wants to give in. There's comfort in the oblivion of dreams. You represent the part that isn't ready to quit and die.
Wait, are you telling me I'm not real?
You're as real as anything else in this place.
So there are two of me?
Yes.
And the one you called Mr. Scratch, he's me as well?
No.
Zane, are you playing some kind of game with me?
I am not the author of your story.
How can you say that when you wrote that page about me and the clicker? It wasn't one of my pages. You directed me to it. You had Weaver guard it.
Yes, she was needed. And you needed the clicker. But I'm not.
What? I don't understand.
Alan, you should keep going.
Zane? Zane, come on!
Well, that cleared things up.
Crazy story. It's very interesting. It's almost hard to tell who exists and who doesn't. Wait. Oh, okay. I'm like, I can't move anymore. Oh. Right. Okay, here we go. More combat. Easy peasy. Yeah, this one, well, I mean, it's all weird, so I don't know, I was gonna say, this one gets really weird, but it's all weird, and the explanations are just wild.
The bridge groaned in the unnatural wind. It was heralding the enemy's arrival. Wake wouldn't leave this place alive.
Yeah, see, this is what I was remembering when we played the main game, because I'm like, I definitely remembered there's a part on the game in the game where you... Oh, okay. Oh, okay. I get it. Certainly makes you feel cool. Ooh, I'm glad that works. I was definitely on par to be a hit straight to the face. What to do? What to do? So many options. Oh. I was just trying to see where it would come from. Oh.
A moment. I can help you here.
How the hell are you doing that?
It's like learning to control your dreams. There's a connection.
You were in my dream.
Area.
Yes. I taught you. You fixed the foolish mistake I made with Barbara.
Barbara? This is very interesting. It's a lot of stuff to come back and remember, but it's still crazy, because it's still like, even if you get down to understanding just the main story of the game, the whole concept of the game is... This dude wrote himself out of existence. Alan Wake wrote his own story so that he could escape being taken over by the darkness. In said escape, he basically wrote a page where Thomas Zane was able to come back, write a page that technically already existed before, you know, before Alan Wake even actually became a writer. And then the pages existed for decades and decades. But technically, that page where the story says Alan got that page didn't exist until Alan was taken underwater. It's technically time travel. It's a time travel writing story. It's a supernatural time. Would you stop? Oh, okay. Everybody stop. Back off. I'm just gonna get rid of you from a distance. Ah, come on. Nope. You can actually hear how many bullets he puts in. Yeah, it's a crazy story. It is technically a time travel. It's a supernatural time travel story, technically speaking. Because he wrote that page. He wrote the story of his own escape. Ow, stop, Ed. There's somebody coming up on the rocks here. Oh, there's too many. Oh my goodness. That didn't even help me like I thought it was about to, but I'm alive. It doesn't matter, I guess. Okay. I was gonna say I might switch to the flashbangs, but those things take so long. I'd have to be like instantly ready to use them. It's your breath.
Wake ran for the light. It was pointless. He would never reach it. His life would be snuffed out just as easily as the very thing he thought would save him.
That's cool. I could see that TV from over there. I was like, that's cool. Rickety bridges. That should have taken him down. I thought he was gonna die there. It looked like because he was in my way, I was gonna come up short on the jump.
You have a lot of problems, Al.
Oh, I'm still looking around.
Since we're being so frank here, Alan,
this is a weird one.
Just reiterate how happy I am that you've had this breakthrough.
I just want to be in the cutscene.
By all means.
And please just let me know if you think I'm being unfair.
All right.
Well, let's start with the obvious: the car crash, untreated head trauma. All due respect to Doc Nelson, but he's hardly a neurosurgeon. I think that the injury has affected you more than you realize.
Yeah, I have had bad headaches.
Then there's your history of substance abuse, which, combined with your chronic insomnia, has resulted in hallucinations and extremely poor impulse control. That's a dangerous combination, one which your wife has unfortunately had to suffer from far more than you.
I know. I know she has.
I don't think I'm exaggerating when I say that you are existing in a state of all-encompassing denial. Your vivid fantasy casts you as a heroic victim and allows you to skirt responsibility for your own actions. It allows you to solve your imaginary problems and dismiss the things that truly trouble you. In your self-serving delusions, your personal problems are assets that allow you to save Alice, perhaps even the world.
Dr. Hartman, I think that's spot on. I can't argue with any of that.
Well, I'm sure I'm stating the obvious. I don't want to labor the point, but, well...
I wish this was almost just a cutscene instead of me having to hold the button down.
I understand. It's important that I face it.
Precisely, Alan. You've put so much effort and imagination into this self-deception, but what good has it really done for you? You refused my offer of help.
Oh, you can't walk in the middle.
Did being so obdurate really get you to a better place?
No.
Obdurate. No.
And did it really help Alice? Was this really the best thing for your wife?
Probably not.
Probably not. Why don't we find out? You know, I've been talking with her. There's something she wanted you to hear.
Oh, hey. That sounds like fun.
All I ever wanted was to help you, Alan. I ate all the shit you handed out and tried
to understand
your pathetic, wealthy white male drama. Until my life consisted of managing your never-ending crisis. I hate you for your childish temper and the arrogance and self-indulgent pride that undermine all efforts to drag you out of the hole you insisted on digging for yourself. I hate you for leaving me in the dark with that insane monster bitch. All you had to do was act like a loving human being for once in your life and stay with me. If your dramatic exit hadn't been more important than making sure I was all right, she would never have taken me. I don't know where you went, but that's okay. I don't want to know. I don't think I'll ever be all right. The only thing that keeps me from killing myself is the hope that I'll never see you again.
And darkness be trying to mess with his head for sure.
I just can't argue with that. I think I should stay here before I ruin what life she has left.
I think this is a breakthrough, Alan. I'm really very proud of you.
Okay. I wasn't ready for that. Tools and a tremor.
It was nonsense. I knew I'd saved her. I'd succeeded in that. And that was all that mattered. What I heard in there wasn't the truth. It was just another toxic mirage. It cut deep, but that made me all the more determined to force myself to snap out of it. I didn't want to be that guy anymore.
Right, it's the plan.
I had to make myself see the light.
Toxic Mirage is a good band name. And, you've heard these things before? No. Well, I probably didn't need the lights. That's fine. What? Okay.
Oh, jeez!
That's weird. Because, it's another game. When we looked out the window, we looked at the tools and the trimmer thing, and then we were on top. We went up a level, and then the room wasn't there anymore. He's falling through. Oh, thank goodness. Yeah, we might as well find it. Those classic 360 sounds calling to me. Ooh, I can't believe he missed. Oh, this is the perfect time. No, of all the times. It's like the one time I wanted a flashbang to go off. We are out of here. Holy crap. Oh, jeez. You can stay back there, dude. Getting the safety. Goodness.
Well done. You have come far, but there's still a little further to go. You must take full control of your own mind. Reject all of the fantasies you have constructed.
Yeah, well, I think I can do that. A lot of the stuff I've seen here is personal and ugly as hell. I'll admit it hurts, but it's not fooling me. I know it's fake.
Good. You are aware. The part of you bent on self-destruction is not. But you must be careful. Just because you know the lies for what they are, that doesn't make the danger any less real.
I'll make it. I don't have any choice.
Here. I cannot come any further, but this will help you on your way.
Thanks, I guess.
Okay.
Hey, let me tell you something, Alan. I know how your mind works. You screw up, then you start analyzing it, and before you know it, you start writing all these horror stories in your head. Don't you?
Come on, I don't do that.
Yes, you do. I know how it goes. You're a complete failure. I hate you and I'll never forgive you for whatever it was that you did. Am I wrong?
Oh, man.
See? I know you. But, Alan, it's all in your head. It is. I love you. and I'm not going anywhere.
Darkness is trying to get him to succumb to his worst fears. The one woman he loved will never love him. They screwed up. Okay. I appreciate that.
They kept coming. There were too many of them. Hordes and hordes of them. Swarming over the landscape, eager to kill. They were coming to wake. And this time they began with sheer numbers.
Yeah, this is cool. Really good segment. I can barely see anything. That didn't help. Whoa. You know what? Let's do this. Okay, I figured it out. Ew, let's run. Let's see where the heck I'm going. Stand back. Yeah, that's right. Back off. They're blinded by the light, as they say. That very famous song. I think I only have... Yeah. Ooh. I think this is the time. You know what? Yep, let's... Try to... Okay. I'm really glad that at least one of them was hit by that. Ooh. That was excellent timing. If only I could effing see. The light leaves you and you're... Ooh! Crap! Oh, boy. I can just... Ah. Ooh. Oh, man. No. Ah, they got me. Dang. Yeah, he started at the checkpoint, and it's literally him tired. Okay, we got one flare. Okay, you know what? We'll just bring them back. This is what I'll have to do. That was not the right button. Not even the right button. Okay. Alright, we'll wait for the next light to pass. All I gotta do is keep them back, and we'll be good on this one. Victory and checkpoints. Okay. I'm like, they're gonna come out when I get in, so I might as well just book it and hope they get hit. Keep it moving. Try to get stuff from as far away as possible. I could time this better too, technically, but I'm kind of just running. So we're running up the path to the lighthouse. That's where we are right now. And ooh, hello. Good day to you, sir. So we're running up the mountainside, pretty much. And the two halves, like the two sides of the two sides of the light are passing us. And so he just turned to look at something. So we basically have to go at the light and try to just time it as best we can. So, oh, hey, hey, hey. I thought we were over. I thought it was over.
The lighthouse. Here. I was relieved to have made it here, but I wasn't sure what was going to happen now.
Up, is it down?
Zane,
only thing I can tell is it's that way. I wasn't probably sure past it.
Presence had done to him if he couldn't follow, but from now on I was on my own. Still, he had gotten me this far. I would never have made it by myself. This thing was going to end. It wouldn't be long now.
It was down there somewhere, but meh. No biggie. Oh no, I'm dead. No, I'm fine. We're fine. I literally can't see. A bit of darkness covered up the spotlight. Oh, that's fine. That's a million times brighter than the actual gameplay was just now.
Surprised by
that makes sense, symbol, I guess.
But not much. I was starting to understand the symbolism, the way the dark place flowed.
Wow, it's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right.
Video game style.
Feeling kind of depressed here.
What?
So Zane's your new buddy now. I feel abandoned.
This is ridiculous. You're not even real.
That doesn't mean I don't have any feelings.
Could have just been a straight path, but nope. Gotta be crazy.
Thing is, you need to get all rational here. Abandon your fantasies, right? Well, I kind of hate to say this, pal, but I'm one.
Fine. You're abandoned. Bye.
Al, what I'm saying is the only way you're getting in that cabin is through me. It's one of those kill your darlings things. But hell, you're used to that, big shot writer. Am I right?
It was in everything. It was even taking a people Wake do, turning his friends against him. They were all against him.
What does it say about you when you're this desperate to keep yourself from getting
better?
Here we go! I'm earning the
50% permission.
Wow, that thing lasted for a long time. I thought for sure I was gonna have to use the battery.
Make yourself an imaginary
friend,
and then
you can't even get along with
that guy. People skills, Al. You're a master.
And now we fight imaginary Barry.
Let's
and Hartman.
Of yours, Alan. An expert on
murder in dark alleyways.
And a master of
substance abuse.
That's the
best part.
Oh, did I only have one? I thought I picked up a bunch of flares for some reason. I was incorrect. Okay. Well, this is about to go different than I thought it was about to. And in case you didn't remember this, from when I went through control, Hartman is the guy that's the crazy monster in that game. In the final DLC for Control, that was Hartman. Loaded a couple more shells in.
It's totally not
fitting.
And you have to literally pay
your best friend
to hang up because of
surly ass.
What in the world? Ah, the stupid things on the ground. I was just about to say, he was oddly the easiest one. Just gotta keep burning him away. I like that he's still technically, see-through.
God, you're driving me nuts.
Oh, and now he's fast. Great. I got 10 shots on me. I think if I don't aim, he'll actually run up on me. It was a nice little bit of time to try to hit him with the hit him with the charge. Okay, I'm just gonna run away from him, and then maybe he'll chase me, because pointing the light at him. Okay. Thought we had something. Because he's just moving too much. Okay. We'll see if this is, yeah. I just got the achievement for Kill Your Darling. So it was the Rule of Three. Classic. Now we enter the cabin. It's like Evil Dead. You gotta have a good cabin to go back to.
Why is this happening to me?
More Cheez-Its.
It's too dark. Where am I? I can't find my way. Why is this happening to me?
Oh, my butt.
Why is this happening to me?
Readjust.
Just like that, my mind was clear. Zane had been right. I could think clearly again. But I couldn't survive in this place the way he had, and I might not make it back a second time. Leaving this place would be hard. Maybe impossible. take much for my thoughts to stray again. It was too easy to get lost in the dark place. Before, I was ready to curl up and die, let myself slip away. But here I was, the yet unwritten future waiting to unfold before me. A sequel to Departure.
Kind of like Revival or something. Return, that's what I was.
I'm a writer.
That is Alan Wake. Fun. Nitro Games. I don't think there's much. Yeah, but I only found half the standees, so missed some extra little information there. But that's the game. That is all of Alan Wake officially. So I'm gonna jump back out, quit this. It might freeze the thing a little bit when it ends. Probably. Let's see. Yep, there it is. Messes up both sides. Like, both screens just get a little wonky. So hop on over. We'll play some Alan Wake's American Nightmare. This one actually captured because I still have to go through the separate thing. And unfortunately, that means it's going to get wonky again. Because it's dumb. Let's do that. Just because I know it's about to. Nope. Actually, there we go. That's what I should have done. Actually, got to make sure I make that thing now. And also, I didn't mention this before. I'll be right back screen. I forgot it's got to be like this because of how weird everything is. It has to be brought up. So unfortunately, you're just seeing darkness right now. Well, there you go. Alex American Nightmare. All my games. I probably only beat like less than half of these things. But yeah. That's Steam for you, I guess. Let me do this. I wish I could also read this, but I can't because this junk shows up so small, it's ridiculous. It is the most ridiculous. I don't understand why I have this issue. I'm also going to toss the music on for a minute. Wait, we at least got something to listen to as I attempt to figure out what this itty bitty little text says. So here we go. I'm just going to bring it on over this way because I literally have to do this just so I can read what the F this junk says. That's how dumb this is. Like, see how tiny that text is? That's what I have to deal with. For some reason, that's what I deal with. It's like this itty bitty little text. I do not know why. Dude, oh my goodness. You can't even freaking see much on this thing. Utterly ridiculous. There's just no reason. There's no real reason that this is what should be happening when I split, when I try to do two screens. But this is what happens. Let's see. I don't think that was it. That's how tiny the text is. I literally can't see. Oh, no, that was it. That was it. There we go. All right, we can end our music. Didn't know that was gonna.
I'm gonna tell you a secret.
Jump into the trailer that actually caught me off guard.
Fiction and dreams can come true, powered by the dark energies leaking from beyond. These places are a battlefield.
That's ridiculous, though.
Between the powers of
light. Here's a separate trailer for Alan Wake's American Nightmare. That is a shame.
I'm Alan Wake, a writer, a creator. I know the rules of the game.
I think it's because my monitors are
fiction that can change the world.
Different sizes.
Power that can bend reality to my will.
Oh, it's you.
Something horrible is coming. He's called Mr. Scratch. He's after my wife, Alice.
Do you know the real difference between us?
I'm not afraid to be the center of attention.
I can't return to the real world. I've tried, but I'm operating on dream logic, forcing the door open a crack so I can slip through. Fiction wants to come true. All you need to do is help it achieve its potential. Under these peculiar, exceptional circumstances, any story, any urban legend, any lie can come true.
They definitely did some cool, unique stuff in this one, as far as like the enemies. So we'll definitely get into that as they go through all that good stuff. And then we have the arcade action, but we'll go story mode. Alan Wake's American Nightmare. I think this was 2012, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, so this is 8 years old. Barry Wheeler. And of course, he did end up managing the Old Gods of Asgard.
He is chasing a dangerous quarry, the Herald of Darkness. His evil doppelganger, known only as Mr. Scratch.
That's a cool effect, too, to put on that.
I'll catch you eventually!
Maybe. But what are you gonna do then? By then, I'll have had my hands on everything you love.
Has been brutally spat out from the darkness that surrounds the shores of our reality. He has come to fight a decisive battle in Night Springs.
I feel like the model looks a little bit better in this one. Maybe they actually did do some. Oh, great. I did not turn off the HUD. I don't know if... Well, fading. Fading is probably good for this one. You actually have to do a decent... I can't. It's just gonna have to be off. Like, I can't do it now. I'm like, the whole game was just... It was just the wide open screen. I was like, nope, can't go backwards now. Can't go back. Oh! Dropping frames. What the deuce? Oh, you know what? Hold on a second. I know what happened here. I need to do something. Not this. Oh my goodness, this 18-mile long screen. Boop. Did that. And also get rid of that. There we go. I actually have to click back into the game too. There we go. Yeah, 60 frames per second. Oh, okay, 60 frames per second. I definitely forgot, like, once I did the... Oh, still feels like a couple frames dropping. That's odd. That's really weird. Yeah, because I can see it's not sticking at 60. I don't understand why that's the case. Like, I'm literally, I can see that as soon as I turn, like, it drops below You see. Maybe this might actually be too powerful. Right, we'll see. We shall see. Because I do have my stuff, like, excessive. Do medium. We'll see what happens. Nope. Still dropping frames. That is weird. I don't know why that's happening. That is very weird. And now it's suddenly fine. Zero drop frames. Okay. Oh, and then it just dropped again. This is the weirdest thing ever. I don't understand at all what in the world is happening here. That is very odd. I'm gonna have to figure that one out. That's super weird. And I wouldn't think, I mean, the game looks a tiny bit better, but it's not like we went from the first Alan Wake straight to Control, all on PC. And it's like, okay, I could see that taking up a decent chunk of, you know, the hard drive, you know, the GPU, as well as the CPU for all that stuff together with the streaming. But I don't get this. Where we literally just started the game up, and then it's just like I'm standing still, and it still was showing frames dropping. That is interesting. Yeah, that is very odd. Okay, so maybe what we'll do, maybe we'll end it for tonight, and we'll go tomorrow, and hopefully, I'll be able to figure out whatever this weird issue is, because I definitely don't get it. Once it's just the game, that should have solved all the problems, because that was literally what it was last time, or when I first started the main campaign, that's what it was. It was the same thing, and it was just like, boom, it's solved, because it's not actually super weird. Yeah, so I will end it tonight. We will start up Alan Wake's American Nightmare tomorrow, and hopefully I'll figure it out by then. I have no idea what the problem is, but I'll try to figure something out. So we'll end it for now. We'll end things out here. I'll just pause it. So I don't know what the deal is. That sucks, because I was definitely ready to keep going. I have to figure that one out. I really don't understand what the problem was there. It makes no sense whatsoever. But I will try to figure it out. It's 11:35. It's a good time to end it, considering I've been up so late the past couple nights. Might be a good excuse for me to just go to sleep. But thanks for joining me. If anyone checked this out way after the fact, hope you guys enjoyed the end of Alan Wake. I do not remember how long the streams actually last, so I will have to kind of just randomly let people know, because I'm probably not going to download them and put them up on YouTube, so it'll, once they're gone, they'll just be gone. I'll have to look through, though. Maybe kind of clip some highlights. I think there were definitely some moments. I think I'm going to clip the farm segment, because that's like my favorite part of the whole epic game. So I might do that. I might clip that and put that on YouTube. But otherwise, end of Alan Wake officially, at least as far as the main first game, and then we'll jump into Alan Wake's American Nightmare. And I do believe this was... I mean, if we've done a little over 2.5 hours tonight, I feel like this was 3 to 4 hours. It was one of those sorts of deals. So I think it's 3 to 4 hours by itself, if I'm not mistaken. But either way, I will try to figure out whatever this weird issue is that I'm having. I'll have to do like my little test streams and see what is and is not missing here, but it literally should not be a problem in any way, shape, or form. Actually, I'll tab out of that. But yeah, that's a weird one. So unfortunately, it'll just be what it'll be for now. But thanks for joining me for this one. I'll do what I can to figure out what the weird issue is with Alan Wake's American Nightmare. See if there's some issue with the game itself. And that was another thing. I don't know if that's just in general doing, you know, full screen with the dual monitors, like where every time you click out of the game, it undoes everything. But it didn't do that with Among Us. I was able to alt tab out of Among Us, and like literally nothing would change. Like there was no issue whatsoever. So I feel like it's specifically, it might be due to the fact that the games are just so old that it was just like, oh, why are you exiting out? And then it has to like distort everything. So we shall see what happens. But either way, thanks for joining me tonight. Hope you had a good time with it. The conclusion, official conclusion of the two little DLC segments. And I wish I knew, maybe it's here. Maybe American Nightmare is the one that has like the crazy horde mode. So we'll probably kind of play around with that a little bit. But thanks for joining me. And I'll try to figure this out and try to make sure we're good to go tomorrow. And that'll probably be around the same time, probably later tomorrow night. But thanks for joining me, and I'll see you tomorrow.